Kenya is a marginalized and an underdeveloped region in Kenya, majorly inhabited by pastoralist communities who are mostly dependent on livestock as their lifeline. It is isolated by its topography and poor infrastructure, compounded by ineffective security provision. Underdevelopment, poor infrastructure, poverty, food insecurity, isolation, and challenging natural environment produce high levels of risk and vulnerability to this region. The region has significantly been plagued by proliferation of small arms, with the problem worsening significantly in recent times. The region has thus developed a gun culture that has been reinforced by chronic insecurity. This has led to a security dilemma. Thus, the pastoralists in this region increasingly find themselves fighting for their survival. Once regarded as being positively associated with higher productivity and industrialization, urbanization has in recent times increasingly brought negative consequences associated with the concentration of economic activities and overpopulation. Like in other parts of the world, over-urbanization in Kenya's urban settlement has resulted to poverty, land dispute, income inequality, unemployment, particularly among the youth, increase in criminal activities, militia groups, insecurity, terror attacks, inadequate housing, inadequate access to public services, and environmental degradation. All these challenges have contributed in one way or another to conflict among different communities residing in Shalom's target area in Kenya's urban settlements.
Shalom Center was founded in 2009, and its main focus is addressing the underlying causes of conflict and poverty. We work up along the Kenyan border where it interfaces with Somalia, Ethiopia, South Sudan, and Uganda. Our vision is in Africa to have a society where peace, social justice, and reconciliation prevails throughout the continent. And secondly, to do this, we have a mission to empower local communities through qualified teams of peace and development practitioners to work for a society free of physical violence, but not just physical violence, also to transform society from having unjust social structures so that it gives a chance for all people to meet their basic human needs and actualize their potential.
Shalom has done in-depth research and analysis of the underlying causes of conflicts where 31 ethnic communities across Kenya are involved.
Tukaanza kufanya mambo ya amani kule Kabtir, Kakong, na Kwamoru, Lorogon, mpaka hata Kainuk. Ikakwa siku moja Shalom akatuingilia kati mwaka wa 2011. Ilikuwa ngumu sisi kukutana na Turkana. Wale wa Shalom wakakuja kutuchukua, wakachukua komiti ya Turkana, wakachukua komiti ya Pokot, tukaenda kukutania kule Kitale, tukamsukumza. Kutoka kule, tukakuja kuelewa kwamba ni mzuri kukaa pamoja.
Some of the major causes that have emerged from the research are competition of access and control of resources, particularly water, pasture, land, livestock and extractives. Proliferation of small arms and light weapons. Institutional deficiency manifested in the diminishing roles of traditional governance systems. Marginalization. Livestock raids and counter-raids. Political incitement. Infrastructural insecurity. Unemployment. Negative ethnicity informed by historical injustices. Conflict memory.
Sisi kama wamama wa hili sehemu, tumeathirika zaidi kwa mambo ya ukosaji wa amani. Kwa sababu kweli kukiwa na amani, amani ni kitu nzuri zaidi. Tunaweza kwenda kwa mashamba, tunaweza kutembea mahali popote, tunaweza kwenda kununua hata vitu kwingine na bila wasiwasi.
As a result of these conflicts, the local communities have suffered several negative impacts as follows. Loss of many lives, widespread destruction of properties. Many schools have been completely destroyed and children miss the opportunity to learn. Massive loss of livestock. displacement of hundreds of thousands of people from their homes, leading to high levels of starvation and malnutrition among the displaced groups, increased hatred among ethnic communities, disruption of social economic activities and livelihood systems, low investment and reduced economic activities, destruction and closure of education and health facilities, stalled development projects, high level of starvation and environmental degradation, along with the threat to water catchment areas.
Hii ndio baadhi ya shule ambayo iliwachwa na kwa sababu ya vita. Katika kwa ile hali ya chuki na kutopendana, wenzetu wakatoka ngambo, wakakuja, ufika huku wakitafuta mbuzi na ng'ombe na kondoo. Ndiposa sasa walipata hapo watu wakaua. Kwa hivyo walipoua watu, shule ikawachwa hivyo, watu wakahamia kwingine. Na baada hapo sasa hasara yenye iko iliyopo na ile tunaiona.
Through its professional and experienced staff, the organization is committed to create a peaceful environment where the most vulnerable, marginalized and poor population or communities can live in dignity and safety in order to fully exploit and maximize their own potential. This has been done through Shalom's intervention methodology. SCCRR has studied and continues to research on the underlying and emerging causes of conflicts amongst conflicting communities in order to carefully counter rumors, conjecture, speculation, propaganda, and wrong information that can be used in fueling the conflict. Research provides the basis and foundation of SCCRR's interventions.
Shalom alituletea amani kubwa sana hapa kwetu. Hakuna taabu mingi saa hii tuko naye na familia yetu yote.
Wakati Shalom ilipoingia kutuhamasisha mambo ya amani na kutuelewesha kuweza kuhamasisha kila kabila namna ya kuishi na namna ya kusamehe mwenzake.
The organization works with organized community groups that are taken and empowered with peace-building techniques and conflict transformation skills that enable them to become peace agents tasked with engaging members of their respective communities. SCCRR conducts problem-solving workshops that are geared towards joint community activities. The communities identify their conflict issues and together develop solutions to challenges to peace in their own communities. Shalom's peace education strategy entails establishment of inter-ethnic and inter-religious schools in areas entrenched by conflicts through establishment of peace clubs in the targeted schools and provision of peace education trainings with both peace clubs members and peace club patrons. The strategy is designed to inculcate a culture of peace and stability among the young generation from this community.
Tuishi,
tuishi, tuishi kwa amani.
Pokoti turukana,
tuishi kwa amani.
Tulime mashamba yetu,
tuishi kwa amani.
Amani, upendo ni umoja. Ndiyo msingi imara, amani, upendo ni umoja. Ndiyo msingi imara, sisi sote tuimize amani. Ndiyo msingi imara, sisi sote tuimize amani. Ndiyo msingi imara.
SCCRR recognizes the value of the nexus between peace and development. Only limited peace is possible without development, and violent conflict destroys development. Informed by this reality, SCCRR supports in the rebuilding and development of local-based institutions ranging from schools, primary, secondary and universities, health facilities, and religious institutions. The organization has provided these institutions with solar panels, laboratory equipment, desks, chairs, books, beds, fencing materials, water tanks, construction materials, to name but just a few.
Shalom Center for Conflict Resolution and Reconciliation has actually supported this school since then up to now. We have received 3 pit latrines, one for boys, one for girls, and one for the staff. from Shalom. We also have received a kitchen. They have constructed a kitchen cum store. Also, a full classroom has been constructed with desks and books, textbooks for all levels from class 1 to class 5. They have also supported the staff by giving chairs and tables and 5 cabinets for storage of books. They have also constructed a teacher's house that has refrained teachers from long distance walking of 700 kilometers a term into 3 meters to the classroom. This is a big relief for us through their support, because now we are getting a lot of energy. We are preserving a lot of energy compared to when we used to walk from Simale to Tum Center. Our friends of Shalom have been a very big gift to us, and we really recommend and even pray that wherever they are, we really appreciate their support.
Nashukuru Shalom kwa kutuletea madawati ya walimu na madawati ya wanafunzi na vitabu ya kusoma ya wanafunzi.
Engagement and collaboration with government, religious institutions and civic society organization is a bedrock requirement for SCCRR's interventions and fundamental to its achievements.
We are neighboring with the people of Parkati, who are Turkanas by tribe, and our side we are Samburu. Previously, before Shalom came in, we had a lot of conflict because we have a lot of cattle wrestling. We have displacement of persons and so many problems. Even it has affected our people negatively in terms of schooling. The number of enrollment in schools, in our schools, has gone down. But now, since when they came in, we have seen several improvements in enrollment, people living in peace, people now living permanently. They start building the houses and doing development.
The organization has engaged governments, religious institutions, local NGOs, academic institutions through research and sharing of research findings, roundtable meetings and trainings.
On behalf of Suguta Marmara community and the Catholic parish, we say thank you for this donation of the microscope. We also say thank you for the 20 benches, 20 tables and 40 benches they've donated to us, and an energy-saving jiko for our kids at the primary school. And they've also been our partners in medical services. They've assisted us to refurbish our dispensary that had closed down a long time ago. We requested for some funding from them to help us bring back our dispensary to its state, operational state. Is a dispensary that had closed down 3 years ago, and gradually we are opening it up. Really, thank you very much, Shalom.
Shalom is currently working in 22 conflict environments, reaching out to 30 operational project areas and engaging 18 ethnic communities who were directly affected by violent conflict across the 11 counties.
The greatest strength of Shalom is that Shalom works in conflict areas to bring about peace and sustainable development among men and women of all faith. This is because conflict knows no ethnicity and no religion.
Shalom is currently working with 31 established peace groups that consists of 1,300 key influential stakeholders in the target project areas. In 2018 alone, the organization conducted 176 peace-building and conflict transformation trainings targeting 2,984 members of the peace groups across 11 counties. These groups engaged 200 other community groups in their respective communities through community awareness forums.
In the past 10 years, Shalom has managed to train 13,000 community leaders across northern Kenya and urban settlement. Since 2012, the organization started working with established community groups in its project areas in 11 counties in Kenya. As from 2017, the organization has been working with 31 established peace groups that have in turn engaged other community groups in their respective communities. in 2018, the peace groups engaged 2,000 other community groups. In an NRM project in Turkana West Pokot borderline, the four NRM committees facilitated the development of natural resource use plans in Turkana West Pokot borderline. The peace groups that we've been engaged with are also involved in problem solving and intercommunity dialogue forums. Over the past 4 years, Shalom has managed to facilitate 5 problem solving workshops and 12 intercommunity dialogues across Northern Kenya. The benefit of these forums and negotiation have resulted to the opening of roads that were closed as a result of conflict, inter-ethnic conflict in these areas, the sharing of natural resources that were previously contested, the return of over 3,000 livestock that were raided from one community to another, the reduction of conflict incidences, particularly raids that were prominent in these communities.
Among the 1,300 trained community leaders, 500 have qualified as community facilitators, engaging over 5,000 community groups, a strategy towards guaranteeing community participation and sustainability of peace and conflict transformation.
Hapa ni sehemu inaitwa Lardabash. Hapa ni pahali, ilikuwa ni pahali kwa sasa watu wanaishi, lakini wakati kuna insecurity ama mambo ya vita ama uoga, inaenda juu alafu ni pahali watu wanapigana. Lakini kwa sasa watu wameanza kurudi kukaa hapa baada ya kuona kwamba mambo ya insecurity imepungua. Baada ya Shalom Center for Peace na mambo ya amani imekuwa pamoja na community kuintervene na other partners, ndio sasa tumeona mambo ya amani umeweza kuwa bora.
Over the years, Shalom has equipped 13,000 key influential community leaders with peace building and conflict transformation skills through series of trainings, a mean of 1,300 trainees annually since the year 2009. Since 2011, Shalom has seen an increase in the number of women in peace building processes, particularly among the pastoralist communities, achieving at least 35% with an annual increase of about 2% across all its project areas. Some women are now taking leadership positions and playing decision-making roles that were previously reserved only for men, as defined by their cultural practices.
However, since 2011, SCCRR has seen an increase in the number of women in peace-building activities and processes, particularly among the pastoralist communities, achieving at least 35%, with an annual increase of about 2% across all its project areas. Currently, we can see women now taking leadership positions and playing key decision-making roles that were previously reserved for their male counterparts, as defined by their culture. We are happy to report that currently in Turkana, Samburu and West Pokot, for instance, Shalom has empowered women and enabled them to design and manage local development projects. Currently, we can now see women in formal peace and reconciliation initiatives, as well as local governance structures.
Mimi ni mama ya Samburu kutoka tu. Shalom imeonesha sisi maendeleo mingi. Baka sisi kina mama naingia mkutano kutembea area hii mingi kutoka Parketi Seisei mpaka Somali. Sisi nakaa pamoja na watu yote Turkana na Samburu kusikisa.
In conflict environments, young people are often the key perpetrators as well as victims of conflict. Shalom has realized against its target an increase in the number of youth ranging 18 to 35 years participating actively in peace-building initiatives in their communities. Over the years of Shalom's work in the target areas, the number of youth has been on the increase between 2% and 4%. The involvement of youth has led to considerable reduction in livestock raiding among the pastoralist communities, as a result of the increasing number of warriors or Morans who were gradually reforming and abandoning their orientation towards livestock raiding and killings.
Tumekuwa na mafundisho mengi na Shalom pamoja na Caritas hapa Karubangi kuhusu mambo ya conflict management. Kwa hivyo mimi kama kiongozi nimejaribu kuwahushisha na kwa maisha vijana ya kwamba wakae vizuri pamoja na jamii katika eneo lao.
Over the past 4 years, Shalom has conducted 5 problem solving workshops and 12 inter-community peace dialogue forums in northern Kenya and urban settlements. This strategy has occasioned the revival of 4 markets, examples being in Samburu, Intum, and Parkati, Longewan, and Morijo. Being pastoralist, the people depend on livestock markets for them to be able to raise income for educating their children and creating more livelihood opportunities. The organization has established Natural Resources Management Committee that have supported the development of natural resources management plans targeting 24 project areas. This has directly impacted socio-economic life of these communities. For instance, the revival of irrigation along the rivers in Turkana and West Pokot borderline has boosted farming in this water-rich semi-arid area. Moreover, there has been a reduction in the cases of conflict occurrence from 3 to 4 in a month to 1 case reported in about 3 months.
Pokot na Turkana ni watu wamesona kwa muda sana. Na wakati Shalom walikuja, walituleta kwanza pamoja kwa kutuita huko Eldoret, walituita huko Kitale, na wakati walituita, walitufunza causes na root causes ya conflict. Na wakati tulifunzwa haya maneno, tuliona ya kwamba sisi Wapokot na Turkana, kumbe sisi ndio tulikuwa shida ya yetu wenyewe. Kumbe tu ni ile natural resources kama vile maji, kama vile nyasi, kama vile hardi. Haya maneno ndio umetufanya kuwa ni vitu ilitufanya sisi tupigane. So kwa saa hii Wapokot na Turkana wameishi kwa amani kwa muda ya mwaka. Sai naelekea kwa mwaka 6 kwa kukaa pamoja. Hii ni kwa sauri ya watu wa Shalom wametufunza, wametuleta pamoja. Hata siwezi kusahau vile hata Shalom amefanya sisi, wametusupport. On the other hand, wamesupport sisi kama vile mashule ya huko Masol, wamesupport shule ya Takwel, wamesupport hata mashule ya upande ya Turkana.
While conflicts render roads impassable due to fear of possible attacks, the prevailing peace as a result of Shalom's intervention has helped to secure key sections of these roads in the conflict zones, thus reviving trade and access to other social needs by the communities living there. Cases in Samburu, Tum, Parkati Road. The established peace committees supported by Shalom have facilitated the return of 3,000 livestock and initiated over 50 activities which have contributed to the prevention of latent conflict through locally supported early warnings mechanism.
So because of this amicable peace now we have among the 3 communities, the communities are able to assess the facility, and we've also started or initiated the so-called markets, in commonly known as the SOCOS, where the buyers and the sellers meet together to sell their goods and buy. The Pokot are selling the animals, and the Samburu are providing what they have, which is more of agricultural produce. The Turkana also have their livestock. So in the SOCOS, they are able to exchange their goods, and all of them are economically empowered, besides having all the necessities they need in their social life. Because of this peace we have today, we have good roads which are even reaching the Pokots, the community. So we can have mobile services directly to the community of the Pokot and even of the Turkana who never had those services before.
Tunashukuru pia kwa shule ya secondary ambayo iko pale Takwel. Shalom wamehusika pakubwa kwa kutujengea darasa, na wao pia wamegharimika kwa kuhusisha pia amani saidi eneo la North Pokot, West Pokot na Turkana pia South. So hao pia wamehusika saidi pakubwa kwa kufanya miradi ya maendeleo eneo ile na hata pia eneo letu. Na pia ambayo hasa tumejitoa baada ya watu wetu kukubali mambo ya amani, ambao pia wamekuwa reform warriors, ambao hasa wamewacha mapunduki zao na kukubali pia kuwa wainjilisti wa Mungu.
Through its engagement and collaboration with government, both national and county, Shalom has shared its research findings, trained over 600 security agents, and at least 100 county government representatives, MCAs and other officials on conflict prevention, conflict management and governance. In 2018 alone, Shalom held 9 strategic roundtable and peace-building meetings with county government officials in 9 counties out of the 11 where it works in. As a result of conflicts in target areas, many pupils and students have been forced out of schooling because of insecurity that also causes abrupt migrations. Many learning institutions have been damaged and a number of them closed indefinitely. In 2018, over 594 Peace Club members received training on conflict resolution, and over 59 teachers received peace building trainings as mentors and peace clubs and facilitators of peace education in their schools.
Young people are usually both victims and perpetrators in any violent setting, and these environments have made them potentially violent, creating a dire need to create a culture of peace that is based on education. And it is for this reason that SECR set up a strategy on peace education that is just designed to inculcate a culture of peace and stability among the young generation in every conflict setting. And SECR has managed to establish inter-ethnic and inter-religious schools in these violent areas and established peace clubs that are powerful tools that are used to nurture peace in these areas.
Through Shalom's intervention, 350 schools and development projects in the conflict zones have been completed in 228 schools, 3 peace centers, 2 universities in South Sudan and Kenya, and 3 medical centers. The organization has provided schools and other educational centers with over 2,000 desks, 4,500 textbooks, and 72 solar systems. It has constructed and renovated 45 classrooms, 13 dormitories, 7 teachers' houses, and 21 sanitary facilities. Averagely, every year, Shalom's school projects benefits about 13,000 students.
Shalom has implemented 350 inter-community schools and development projects in different conflict zones in Eastern Africa. Out of the 350 projects, 228 are in schools, where 45 construction and renovation materials have been provided and 21 sanitary facilities constructed. 13 dormitories have been constructed and they have been fully installed with beds and mattresses. This is very important as the girl child is well protected from early marriages and teenage pregnancies. 7 teachers' houses have also been constructed in these conflict zones, and this is very important because teachers have had to walk very long distances. And with this, when they're in schools, now they're able to pay more attention with the students and also to take longer hours teaching. This ultimately has had increased turnover of students, and the performance of the students also increases. Other projects have included 3 medical centers, which have been provided with medical equipment, and 2 universities have been provided with learning materials in South Sudan and 1 in Kenya. Schools and education centers have been provided with about 2,000 desks, 4,500 textbooks, and 72 solar systems. Averagely, Shalom development projects benefit about 13,000 pupils and students in their communities yearly.
In order to improve the hygiene and promote small-scale farming, the organization has supplied an average of 2 water tanks and installed water piping systems. It has also provided permanent fencing to a number of schools in conflict zones, including Loya and Kaputiro primary schools in Turkana and Simale in Samburu counties. SCCR's interventions in these regions through peace education and development projects has greatly enabled peaceful interaction among pupils and students from rival ethnic communities, improved enrollment in schools, increased retention of pupils and students and teachers, bettered schools' performances, and enhanced the uptake of formal education among the children within an environment that is very conducive for learning. There is evident improvement in interaction between communities in all 30 project areas. This is manifested in trading together of rival communities, joint peace building and development initiatives, children of diverse ethnic backgrounds schooling together, sharing of contested resources like water and pasture, sharing of medical facilities, churches, and joint sporting events. Through SCCR's interventions, the communities of these regions are becoming more optimistic and are now enjoying an environment of low conflicts, thus enabling them to concentrate on development projects, as is the case in other parts of the country. Shalom is committed and will continue journeying with the conflict-ridden communities in Eastern Africa, Kenya, Ethiopia, South Sudan, and Somalia, in enabling them to be the architects of their own future by following effective paths to end protracted violence in their societies.
As the Shalom Center for Conflict Resolution and Reconciliation is registered in Kenya, we want to also recognize the support of the government to that process of registration and empowering us through collaboration at a central level and also in the counties, because as Kenya now has brought in a system of devolved administration, we work very, very closely with the county administrations. So as I said at the beginning, we are a group of qualified men and women from all faiths. So I want to express a word of gratitude to our donors around the world on behalf of this group, but not just on behalf of the Shalom group, but on behalf of all the people, the thousands of people that you have been involved in. Like since Shalom started, we have trained over 13,000 people in conflict analysis. As regards the educational interventions of Shalom in the conflict environments, I want to thank all our donors on behalf of the people who live in those conflict environments.